The first 5 to 8 years of a child's life is critical for development, as this is the foundation for subsequent stages. Ideally, children that age should grow and develop in a friendly environment, preferably within a family. But for these boys, home is in the dim and distant past, and survival depends on kind gestures from the public. 10-year-old Umaru is one of many boys sent by their parents from different parts of northern Nigeria to Bauchi State to learn Islam under an informal education system called Almajiri. He, like many others, is not lucky to get food every day. In the same town is 21-year-old Sani, who also joined the Almajiri system at a tender age after his parents sent him here from Adamawa to learn the Quran. His story is a sharp contrast from Umaru's. Rather than beg, Sani learned to be independent and today runs a business of his own and is also studying mass communication at the Bauchi State Polytechnic.
When I started it, I have my Oga shop here. There is one brother, when I will come to his shop immediately in the morning and carry out his lot to here and pack it. We will stay together till the time of my going to school.
Yahaya is a product of a more organized school for Quranic and Islamic studies, which teaches the boys to be financially independent in addition to the usual curriculum. Over the years, Almajiri has become synonymous with begging, but Islamic cleric Mansour Yalwa, while comparing the practice in Nigeria to what obtains in Mauritania, one of the countries Nigeria borrowed the system from, says begging is vehemently discouraged in Islam.
Even though this practice is deeply rooted in the practices of the people, but they were able to outlaw the issue of begging, and it worked. I never saw anyone begging in the street. I didn't see anyone going to the houses begging for food, because the people who are there are philanthropists who will be feeding these children, even if they are there, but they don't need to go and beg.
Addressing the problem is one some members of civil society believe can be achieved by institutionalizing the practice.
The government can go there and build classroom for them, build a hostel for them, allow them to do their normal things the way they used to.
Other solutions proffered include more creation of awareness, especially at the grassroots level, in order to discourage parents and guardians from sending their children and wards to clerics who run the Almajiri schools.